सो गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, दिस इज़ योर लेक्चर नंबर 8। लेक्चर 8, टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द पावर ऑफ लेंस। सो पावर ऑफ लेंस मीन्स हाउ मच लाइट इज कन्वर्ज एंड हाउ मच लाइट इज डाइवर्ज। ओके, सपोज वी हैव टू लेंस एंड द लेंस विच विल कन्वर्ज मोर लाइट, सो means its power is high, or if it converges the light with less angle means its power is low. So let us write the definition of the power of lens. So the power of a lens is a measure of the degree of convergence or divergence of light rays falling on it. Okay, so the power of lens is a measure of degree of convergence or divergence of light ray falling on it. So suppose we have two lenses, two convex lens. So this is first convex lens and let this is second convex lens. Okay, so we can see its curvature is less. Its curvature is less. So its focal length will be less. Focal length will be more. Okay. Its curvature is high. So high curvature means focal length will be less. Okay. So suppose light rays are falling. These are light rays, and after refraction, it will pass through focus. Okay. All the light rays will pass through focus. Here also, all the light rays will pass through focus. Now, how can we see that its power is more or its power is less or vice versa? So, we can see here, if I draw an angle, let this is theta 1, and let this angle is theta 2. So we can see theta 1 is less than theta 2. Means it is converging light with more angle. Okay. And it is converging light with less angle. Means it will converge light way far than the from the lens. So means its power is less. Okay, it can bend light with low angle, means its power is less, and it can bend light with high angle means its power is more. Suppose this is our lens and this is our light, and light is converging at very sharp angle means its power is high, whereas a lens which converts light at the very far distance means its power is low. So the power of lens is a measure of degree of convergence. Degree of convergence for convex lens, or degree of divergence for concave lens. Similarly, for concave lens, if suppose we have a concave lens, and if it diverging light with very sharp angle, it means its power is high, whereas a convex lens which diverges light with low angle, so it means its power is low. Clear? So power means how much light, or we can't say how much light, but if light is converging with very high angle, then its power is high. If light is converging or diverging with relatively lower angle means its power is low. Okay, so the formula for power is, it is reciprocal of focal length. Okay, we can see here the focal length is larger. Suppose this focal length is f1 and this focal length is f2, and we can see f1 is greater than f2, but we also know that its power is high because it is converging light with larger angle. So power of second lens means we can say p2 is larger than p1, means we can see if focal length is larger, power is low. If focal length is greater, sorry, if focal length is high, power is low. If focal length is low, power is high. So these are inversely proportional to each other. Okay, so we can tell power is inversely proportional to the focal length, and the formula for power is equals to 1 upon focal length, but this focal length should be in meter. Okay, so this is our formula, power is equals to 1 upon focal length. Clear? So the unit of power of lens is diopter, and it is denoted by capital D. Clear? Okay, so unit of power is diopter. This is the unit of power. Okay, so one diopter is the power of a lens. When this power will be 1 diopter? So power, we know that P is equals to 1 upon F. If power is 1, when this will become 1? When F is 1, 1 meter. So if then power will be 1 diopter when this is 1 upon 1 meter. So the 1 diopter is the power of lens whose focal length is 1 meter. Okay, so the lens having focal length 1 meter, its power will be 1 diopter. Okay, clear? Now we can see the focal length, we have two signs for focal length. One is positive and one is negative. So we know that for convex lens, focal length F, or we can say focal length F is positive. If F is positive, then power should be positive. So power of convex lens is positive, whereas for concave lens focal length is negative. Focal length F is negative, so the power of concave lens is negative. So you have to keep in mind these two points. When will be focal length positive? If power is positive, then it is convex lens. If power is negative, then the lens is concave. Okay, so power means how much light or light is refracted with larger angle, or light is converged with larger angle, or if it diverge with larger angle, then power would be high. And if it is converging with a lower angle or diverging with lower angle, means power is low. Okay, so this is about the power of lens, how we can calculate the power of lens. So to calculate the power of lens, we only need focal length. Okay, so we can see these two are inversely proportional to each other. Means if focal length is greater, then power is lower. We can see these are inverse relation. Okay, and if focal length is larger, then power is, if focal length is lower, then power will be higher. Clear? So this thing you have to keep in mind. Suppose we have given two lenses and two focal length are given. So by visual, you have to say which whose lens has greater power. So you have tell that the lens having focal length larger will have larger power. Okay, clear? Now suppose we have a question, find the power of concave lens whose focal length is 2 meter. Now first is lens is concave, so lens is concave, okay, and its focal length is 2 meter. So focal length is given in meter, so it is easy question. So f is equals to 2 meter, focal length is 2 meter, but since it is concave lens, its focal length should be negative, okay, and from we know that power is equals to 1 upon focal length in meter, so power is equals to 1 upon minus 2, so power is equals to minus 0.5 diopter. Okay, so this is the power of that concave lens. Now suppose we have given more than 2 lenses or 2 lenses, 3, 4, 5 or n lenses, and we want to calculate the combined power of these lenses. So for example, we have a convex lens of power P1, we have another convex lens of power P2, okay, and we want to calculate the total power of these two lenses. So these two lenses will become a system, and we want to calculate the power of that total system. Clear? So how we can calculate this power? So this is simple. So total power will be the algebraic sum of all individual power of the lens. Okay, so total power will be the algebraic sum of all individual power of lens. So this is how we can calculate the total power. Now what is algebraic sum? Algebraic sum means we have to sum up all powers with their proper sign. So it means that suppose we have a convex lens of power P1 and we have a concave lens of power P2. Now the total power is equals to, we know that the power of a convex lens is always positive. So this is P1 plus, what is the power of a concave lens? So it is always negative, P2. So the total power will be P1 minus P2. Clear? For example, suppose we have a concave lens of power 10 diopter and convex lens of power 5 diopter. Okay, and we want to calculate the total power of the system. Total power of the system. So how we can calculate the total power of the system? So total power is equals to P1 plus P2. Now P1, we know that it is the power of concave lens, so it is negative 10 diopter plus the convex lens of power 5 diopter. So the power of convex lens is positive, so this is 5 diopter. So this is minus 10d plus 5d is equals to minus 5 diopter. So the total system will behave like a concave lens. So the total system will behave like concave lens. Why? Because its power is negative. So power negative means lens should be concave. Clear? So if the total power is positive, the whole system will behave like convex lens, and if the power is negative, then whole system will behave like concave lens. Clear? So this is about the power of lens, the combination of lenses, and how we can calculate the total power of the combined system. Okay? So now we will study the uses of convex lens and concave lens. So this is the only part which is remain in this chapter. So now we will study the uses of convex lens and concave lens. Now class, we will study about the uses of convex lens. Okay, so what are the uses of convex lens? First is, they are used in the spectacles for the correction of eye disease called hypermetropia or long sightedness. So hypermetropia we will study in our next chapter, Human Eye and Colorful World, in details. But you have to keep in mind that to cure hypermetropia we will use the convex lens. Okay, so this is a spectacles in which the convex lens is used. Okay, next is, convex lens is used in microscopes and magnifying glass. So magnifying glass you already know, which can enlarge the image. Okay, this is magnifying glass. So what happens when we put magnifying glass in between the focus and the if we place any object between the focus and the lens, okay, so the image of the object will get magnified. Okay, so we know that the case, in case of convex lens, when an object is placed between F and O, its image is enlarged and erected. So this is the case. Okay, so this is how the magnifying glass works. It is also used in telescopes. So not only a convex lens, but there are multiple lenses here, so which help us to enlarge the very tiny object. Okay, so in microscope, convex lens is also used. Convex lens is also used in cameras. Okay, to focus the light for a clean picture. So here, convex lens is used. Also, concave lens is used. Multiple lenses are used, but convex lens is also used in cameras. So we will not go through the working, how these lenses are work to get the clear picture, but we only want that how convex lens is used, where it is used. Okay, so it is used in spectacles, it is used in magnifying glass, it is used in microscopes, it is used in cameras also. Okay, now the uses of concave lens. So concave lens are used in spectacle for the correction of eye disease called myopia. Again, the myopia we will study in our next chapter, Human Eye and Colorful World, in detail. So this is a spectacle having the concave lens. So here concave lens is used. Concave lens is used in telescope and binocular. So this is telescope and this is binocular, in which the concave lens is used. Again, not only concave lens, but also convex lens is also used. So multiple lenses are used to focus the image. Okay, concave lens is used in flashlight to spread the light towards the wider area. So this is flashlight. Here you can see these are concave lens. So concave lens is diverging lens. That's why when light falls on these lenses, the light diverges, or we can see the wide area. Okay, Next is concave lens is used in peephole. So there is peephole in your door, or we can say spy hole. This where you can see the widened area from this tiny hole. So we know that when light come from the different direction on and fall on concave lens, so after refraction it goes parallel. Okay, so this is how the peephole works. So all the lights coming from the widened area, this much area will fall on this concave lens, and after refraction it goes parallel to our eyes. Okay, so that's how we can see the widened area. So in peephole it is the concave lens which is used. Okay, so these are the uses of the convex and concave lens. Don't go in details how this lens is used to form a telescope, because you will learn this in your 12th class. Okay, so for this time being it is only you to know that how in which places the convex lens and concave lens are used. Okay, so this is all in this topic refraction. Now in next two or three classes we will do the rest of the numerical from the NCRT or the extra. Okay, so in this chapter these are the only things we had to study. Okay, so thank you class.